good. Okay, done. Good. So today we'll be launching our fourth webinar for this series for 2021. And already we've started in October, I think. The first Arduino webinar. So today we will be focusing on Tinkercad. Just one moment, please. Okay, sorry. So today we'll be focusing our webinar on Tinkercad, which is an online solution that provides us with a simulator online, so no need for the hardware. First of all, let me tell you something that from my request on the phone like 2-3 days ago, I've asked you if you already have a prerequisite skills and knowledge in Arduino. And the problem is there is a group that they already know Arduino. There is another group that are new for Arduino. That's why I'll ask the group, the new group that they don't have skills in Arduino. At a certain moment, I will skip a series of slides, and all the explanation, I will send it to you already from the previous webinar I've did in October. So you have three links, YouTube, like for 1 hour and 20 minutes. So you can review this webinar held on October. So in order to understand more the content of what we are talking about. So today, the concentration will be on how to simulate online an Arduino project. But I have to start with a refreshing memory, a series of slides to refresh your memory regarding some concept. So, I will start by the first slide. So today we'll explore all the tools used to make the online Arduino teaching a successful task. As we always said that it's for ICT and science teacher. At the end of this webinar, as usual, I think you are used to. You have the right to receive a certificate of participation. So all you have to do is to send your full name, school name, and email on my WhatsApp. Why Arduino in the ICT curriculum? Or why teaching in general microcontrollers? This is a major problem question we have to answer. You as teachers and even students must know why they have to learn microcontrollers. It's very obvious that nowadays, and we are in our curriculum, right click, I believe that we are among the first to introduce microcontrollers in our curriculum. I remind you, for those who are using and for those who are new to our curriculum, that Arduino is used from grade 10, 11, 12. Microbit, which is the new microcontroller, it will be integrated this year from grade 4, 5, and 6. And we'll discuss during this webinar what to integrate as microcontrollers for grade 7, 8, 9. So if you are using our curriculum, you have to know that, or you have to be proud that you are teaching microcontrollers in an educational way and in a curriculum where it was tested for several years before publishing it. And for those who are new to our curriculum and not using it yet, I highly invite you to ask for specimen in order to discover what's inside. Since ICT, and I repeat always this slide in all my presentations, that since ICT is considered as a science, so in addition to algorithm coding and robotics, microcontroller is a major skill that should be delivered to students. As for students, here we have to pay attention. So as for students, they should be convinced why they have to learn microcontrollers. So if your student are not convinced about what is microcontroller and why they have to follow this curriculum and to discover what are microcontrollers, believe me, you will not succeed in this task. So once they are convinced, I believe that they will be motivated for this part or for this series of chapters. So you have to explain them what is IoT, Internet of Things, where it's implemented, some examples of applications that you can find on YouTube in order to make them understand more and more the utility of microcontrollers. As for you teachers, you should master the skills of microcontrollers, since we believe that once we did our university studies, microcontroller was not really, like we said, as common to be delivered at universities, only just for mechanical or electromechanical engineering. They develop skills in microcontrollers, but in computer science and in computer engineer, I believe it was not a few years ago from now. So for you as teachers, you have to master those skills, which are divided into four main sections. The environment of the microcontroller, the hardware of the microcontroller, the software, and the creativity for ideas and projects. So you have to read, to discover, to follow maybe on Twitter, on YouTube, new projects and new ideas regarding this invention. So at which grade, this is a major question we have to answer. At which grade we should start teaching microcontrollers? So in our curriculum, microcontrollers, the microbit microcontroller is given from grade 4 till grade 6. Arduino is given from grade 10 till grade 12. And from grade 7 till grade 9, for the time being, it's not integrated, but soon for the coming year, we'll develop an extra curriculum in order to be delivered with the books, just to cover the microcontroller skills for grade 7, 8, and 9, since we believe that it is a must. Now, microcontrollers and ICT curriculum is a must. So then I will continue. Why Arduino? Because there is many microcontrollers on the market. You have, I give examples of Raspberry Pi, of Microbit, of Arduino, of Banana Pi. There is many microcontrollers, but Arduino, since it was the first microcontroller to adopt open source platform, I mean, everyone can develop this microchip and add to it sensors and accessories first, it is cheap. It's available on AliExpress or on souq.com, like Amazon, and educational resources are found easily. But the main problem is how to find a suitable curriculum. This is the problem. So if you go through internet and you search for Arduino projects, of course you will find many, but the problem is that you can't integrate them in an educational way in your curriculum, since those projects are made to be done in at home or for university studies, or even at a computer club after class. Please turn off your mic. Can you
please turn off?
Okay, so the obstacles for teaching Arduino are the following. For students, there is a major problem, which is skills in electronic, the hardware, and the time management. For teachers, also mastering electronic skills, it's a must in a certain way. Resources, and especially the support. And here we have for you the solution. If you are at school, I believe now you are teaching online, but if you are at school in a computer lab, each 2 to 3 students, please, can you turn off your mic? Can you turn off your mic, please? Thank you. So if you are at school in a computer lab, and hope we'll be back very soon, each 2 to 3 students must be working on a project. So I mean, 1 or 2 students are working on the hardware design and one on coding. If you are teaching from home or students are home, so we have to go through an online simulator in order to deliver at least a certain amount of skills regarding Arduino. That's why Tinkercad from Autodesk is the solution, and I believe that you will like it, and you will be excited to teach it for your students. So start teaching computer. Arduino is divided into 2 main parts. There is the theoretical part, the concepts of Arduino, and then the practical part, how to build the circuit, the electronic circuit, and how to program it in order to be functional. And the theoretical part consists on explaining the concept of a microcontroller in real world, introduce Arduino as hardware, components, and software. The practical part consists on creating real project with Arduino hardware, developing the coding part to make the hardware operational. Then, since we are online, how to solve this problem? We can easily teach Arduino from home by following a clear and practical concept. And here, I will stop my presentation to go directly to Tinkercad, since the remaining part of my slides, since the first 20, it's like refreshing memory. So the remaining part from slide 22 till slide 69 will be skipped, since it was given in a previous webinar. Once I will send you this PowerPoint link, you can go through those 3 links in order to review the rest of this of the previous webinar on how to animate the first lesson, the second lesson, and so on. So I consider that this part is done. If you have any problem later on in understanding a specific concept, of course you can communicate with me through WhatsApp in order to solve this problem. But the idea now is to continue the second part of the webinar by showing you how to manipulate Tinkercad. So In brief, I have to focus on a main idea, is that teaching Arduino or microcontroller is a must, since you are opening a new future for your student, in order to understand what they can do in life regarding automation, mechanical, computer science, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things. And of course, here we are talking about developing skills in STEAM education. And like a few days from now, I heard the new administration in the US, they are talking about focusing and more and more on the STEAM education, since there is a lack in this issue. So that's why it's very important for our countries and schools to take into consideration this STEAM education into consideration. So for those who are new and for those who knew Arduino, so quickly, this is the hardware, the microcontroller Arduino. This is a rain sensor that can detect rain. This is ultrasonic sensor that can detect obstacles and movement. This is a soil moisture sensor that can detect humidity soil. This is a gas sensor that can detect if there is gas in the air. This is a human body motion detection that can detect any movement in a room. This is a water level tank sensor that can detect the level of water in a tank. This is a motor rotation that can perform a rotation for a mechanical action. This is a humidity and temperature sensor. This is a push button, a seven segment LED display to display numbers, LEDs, and there is, of course, many other hardware that you can integrate in order to start creating project. But as we say in Arabic, لازم نحط إجرينا على الأرض, يعني not to dream too much, but since we are educator, we know very well the capacity of the students, the duration of each period. So this is our approach and how we can combine all those factors in order to give a solution for students, taking into consideration the duration of the period, the hardware, and so and many other factors. So I will say that all those hardware I showed you, you can combine them in a way in order to create a real project. But of course, at the beginning, we cannot mix all those hardware, or at least most of them, in order to create complicated projects. Students must understand how to program each item alone. I mean, how to program the buzzer. I mean, the element that reproduce sound, or how to program the ultrasonic sensor. Later on, when those hardware skills and when those programming skills are acquired by students, you can ask them to create projects that combine, let's say, ultrasonic sensor and buzzer together. I mean, if the buzzer, if the ultrasonic is here, and if the ultrasonic detects an object less than 20 centimeter, let's say, the buzzer will start ringing, or the LED will illuminate, and so on. That's why we have to start by developing skills, each hardware alone, how to install it, how to program it, and then after we'll be developing advanced project by combining all those together. So I will go through directly the Tinkercad website. So you see the welcome page of the Tinkercad. Can you see the Tinkercad project, Manal?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So the idea of this website, first of all, it's a free website. It's made by Autodesk. You have the two options here. Even you can join now, join a class, let's say, or you can sign in. For students, to be honest with you, I did not experiment really the join now feature, because you have to create a class and to ask students to join this class and so on. That's why it's better for you to click or to ask your students to join, to click on sign in. Once they click on sign in, there is many options here. I believe that most of your students have Google, and if they don't have, they can create a new account by creating username and password. So I will access through my Google account. Okay, so I will choose my Google account, this one. I believe this one is the active one. Okay, so as you can see, the layout is simple, not complicated. On your left, you have three sections or four sections. You have in the Tinkercad a section 3D designs that we will develop it later on February 4. Today, we are going to select the circuits design. Okay, all the previous circuits are saved automatically, as you can see here. I have, let's say here, like seven projects already done, and students will be asked to create a new project by creating a new circuit. Once you go through the creation of your new circuit, okay, you will see that on your right, you have what we call the components divided into two categories, the basic category of components, as I showed you, the hardware component, and you have to list all the components that maybe your students are not interested in since they are for advanced users, okay? And as a starter, since you can find a starter project in Arduino or in Microbit. So that's why we'll keep this for later on for you to discover alone at home. So I will keep the basic components, since if I choose all, I will have a bigger list, as you can see here. So, and students will be a little bit lost with it. That's why I will keep for the basic one, okay? And as you can see here, we can see resistors, LED, push button, potentiometer, breadboard, Arduino board, DC motor, LED, RGB photoresistor, ultrasonic sensor, the piezo buzzer. So those components are the basic one that you need in order to start with Arduino, okay? And please keep in mind that once you decide to use Tinkercad for Arduino, you have the full support from us in order to help you providing your students the best you want. So the first thing I have to do is to move a an Arduino board, then I move a breadboard. Of course, I can zoom in and out, as you can see, okay? And I will move a LED just to start showing you how to manipulate those components and a resistor. So first of all, you have to know something very important, that on your left, you have a rotation button. It's very important, since if you want to rotate a specific element, you can make this rotation by, as you can see, 30 degrees, even for the breadboard, sorry. Even for the breadboard, you can rotate it. Okay, just to make your combination of circuit. If you want to make the leg of the LED, as you can see, longer, so you can make it, okay, in order to link it to the breadboard. Okay, and then for the resistor also, you can link it directly to the breadboard. Just you have to know, and even for those who know the sorry, can you turn off your mic, please? Can you turn off your mic, please? Thank you, sorry. So for those who know Arduino and for those who are new for Arduino, I have to remind you that for this circuit, for the Arduino circuit that you can see as a hardware and on Tinkercad, it's exactly the same as you can see it here. It's exactly the same. And quickly, I will show you that there is digital pins here, up and down, okay? For the moment, it's a little bit confusing for you, but you have to know that in electricity, of course, we need the cathode connection and the anode connection, the plus and the minus. So the ground here, this button ground, or this button ground here down, you have two, can provide the zero current volt. The 5 volt and the 3.3 volt can provide also high voltage. And the digital pin, 13, 12, 11, 10, till zero, are digital pins that can provide also 5 volt. So, and later on, you will see how we can manage and program those digital pins once they are used. And down, we have what we call the analog pin, which are A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. The main question is, when we use the digital pin, and when we use the analog pin. So it's very easy for the buzzer. I mean the piezo buzzer that will display sound. Okay, it has to be linked to the digital pin, since this buzzer will reproduce a sound if the current pass, so the value is 1, and the buzzer will not reproduce a sound if the buzzer current is 0. So for the digital pins, they can take only two values, which are 1 or 0. 1, the current pass; 0, the current does not pass. Same for the LED, the LED. So the LED will turn on if the current pass, and will turn off if the current does not pass. For the analog pin, let's say we have to measure temperature, okay? Or we have to measure humidity. So there is, for temperature and for humidity, there is a range of values. That's why we need to link the humidity and the ultrasonic maybe and other components for the analog pin, not for the digital pin. So if you go through videos on YouTube, you will hear specialists in electronic explaining you the idea. I'm not a specialist in electronic, but I have a minimum background in this field, so I can explain it in a clear way. I hope so. So back to my presentation. So once I am in Tinkercad, I am building my circuit. Okay. Suppose that the circuit is done. Of course, here it's not done since there is no link between the Arduino board and the breadboard. There is no link, so it will not function. But imagine that it's done. Once done, you have two buttons to remember always, which are code and start simulation. So the code will open you, as you can see, the block code as for Scratch and the Microbit. And of course, for advanced users, you can switch here to block and text, or even for text, okay? You will tell me, or you will ask me, what is this already done here? Those blocks are by default integrated in the code block, so I can delete them if since I'm building a project from scratch. So all you have to remember that by clicking on code, you will open the screen of code, and you will decide if you will be programming in blocks or even in code. So today we'll be focusing on simple projects using blocks, not the code. Since next week, we will be manipulating Arduino code in text mode, not in block. And once the circuit is done, okay, I will click to start the simulation. Of course, you have here the share and the export. You can discover alone by yourself. So I will try to build a simple project just to show you and to remind you, and for those who are new, about what are the basic manipulation that we can do. So I will drag a LED, and I will place it here on the breadboard. And I remind you that the breadboard is like بيقولوله بالعربي فيش الحرامي بالانجليزي ما بعرف شو بيقولوله منع راسي الفكرة يلي هي الملتيبريز انه بناخد كهرباء من كذا وحدة. So the breadboard will play the role of the connectors in order to expand my circuit. I mean, if I click on this, you can see that all the dots are connected in a horizontal way. In this part, the dots are connected in a vertical way. Those numbers are just for us, since the breadboard is a dummy part, so it's not an electronic part, it's a simple circuit to link dots together in order to create a developed and a complicated circuit. So as you can see here, the breadboard is divided into into three, four main section. You have this section, which is repeated here. You have this section, and you have this section. In the first section, this one, the dots are connected horizontally. And in this section, dots are connected also horizontally. And on those sections here and here, dots are connected in a vertical way. So I insert the lead. As you can see, the leg of the two leads are not the same here. It's a little bit curved. It's the anode, the plus, the positive, where I have to connect the 5 volt. And here it's the cathode. So believe me, even if we are working virtually, student, in all cases, we don't have the choice since students are not in class. But even if they are in class, working on Tinkercad at home or in class will simplify you the task in order to, once you give them the hardware in their hands, they can manipulate it and understand it very well. And even if you are in class, you as teacher, you can project on the whiteboard, the Tinkercad, and to make the circuit, and the student will copy it or will continue it in a way. So what I will be doing here, I will link, look how I will do. I will take a pin from the ground. I will take it. I will click, I will take it, and I will link it directly to the cathode. I will select another pin, let's say the pin, digital pin 7. Okay, I will click, I will take it, and I will link it directly to the cathode. Okay, to the anode. So now the LED should blink if I will run the simulator. But I will have nothing is happened since the code is not written. It's normal. So now it's time for the code to be written. Of course, the LED is an output device. So from the output category, I will select the set pin to high. Okay, I will select pin number 7 since it is linked to 7, as you can see here. From the control section, I will select the wait for 1 second. Then from the output again, I will set the pin 7 to pin 7 to low. High mean that the current pass, it means the signal is equal to 1, and 0 for low. And of course, I will make the wait for 1 second. So now I will run the program. And as you can see, the LED is blinking, but there is a small warning on my code. So I will run it again, and this, it shows that the current, it's a little bit quick, you can see it alone. It said that the current is high, so the LED, after a specific time, it will be burned, so we have to protect it with a resistor. Okay, so and here we'll introduce the concept of resistors for students. Just to remind you that in the previous session of Arduino, we developed those skills alone, what to do in first lesson, in second lesson, and so on. So I'll be clicking on code again. I will stop, and I will select here from blocks even blocks or text, or even text alone. And I can see that the code written in Arduino language is displayed here. So it's easy for you to move step by step for students and of course for grade 10, 11, 12, they can master, and even in the books, there is the Arduino code written not in block, but for lower grades, I believe that it will be a simple mission for you to introduce them to the block programming. So this is what we are thinking about to integrate for lower grades, 7, 8, 9, the Arduino by using those concepts, not by writing the code, but by text, since it will be a little bit difficult. So it was the first project. I will go through the main menu to show you the different projects I've realized previously and with the code. So I will select the one LED with a resistor. Hope it will not take time to load. Okay, so as you can see here, I will see the code. It's done to repeat 10 times, set pin 8 to high, wait 1 second, set pin 8 to low, wait 1 second. But actually, this block will not, or this program will not stop after 10 times, as you can see, since the for loop is written in the void loop. And as you know that the void loop, it's a loop that will run for infinite. That's why in the Thinkercad, it's a little bit difficult to control by using the blocks, the program to turn a specific number of times. So I will skip this this section of the loop counter. So I will move a resistor, because since I click on the as you can see here again, we have the problem of the LED will be burned since there is no resistor. So I will stop it. I will select the resistor, will turn it, as you can see, and will place it anywhere on my breadboard. And since, as we said before, the columns are, or the dots are linked vertically, so the 8-pin, this cable, should be linked. I will move it from here and I will place it here. So if we try to analyze a little bit what I've did, simply I've added a resistor, I will select it, and this resistor should not be 1 kilo ohm. Sure, here you will ask me that how we should know. All the videos, all the documentation online says that the LED needs in ohm 220 to be protected, okay? So it's a concept of electronic. We are not supposed to answer it in a scientific way. So for students, you can answer by that all resources on the internet, and of course the physics teacher can answer in a clear way by a formula what resistors to use for this LED. So here the current will pass from digital pin 8 till this column. The resistor is placed here, and then the current will pass to the anode. So now the as you can see, I will not have a signal of warning, since the resistor will protect my net. So on a code level, nothing will change. By adding the resistor, it will not affect the code. So the first step as projects that you will do with your students is how to integrate an Arduino board, a breadboard, and a LED without any resistor. You will explain them what's happening. The second exercise will be with a resistor. The third exercise will be, I will switch to two LEDs to make them. So here I will select the two LEDs, and the concept is the same. As you can see, the two LEDs are linked in the same way. And the green LED is connected to digital pin 6. And the red LED is connected to 4. And the red one is on digital pin 7. I will open I hope you understand the circuit, how is made, it is made. So the ground, as you can see, I link it to the horizontal row on the upper part of the Arduino board. And then the cathode is connected to directly to the horizontal row. The code is here. I've did a counter from variable. I've created a counter, a variable, a name count. I set the count to zero, and I've tried to turn the loop only 5 times, but unfortunately it did not work, since in blocks programming, I cannot control the if. I have to go through the text mode in order to remove it from, as you can see here, I have to remove it from, look, the while it's correctly written, but I have to move it and place it in the setup mode. So I will try it, and next week we'll talk about it. So if I click on the code block, you can see that the loop will turn, set pin 7 high, set pin 4 low, wait 0.5 seconds, then the inverse. I mean, 7 it will be low, 4 it will be high. And then I will try to run it. And as you will see, there is a kind of blinking between the red and the green. So as you can see, we are making the missions a little bit difficult by adding more components, by adding new blocks in the programming. And believe me, if you follow those steps by going slowly, you as teacher, you will succeed, since it's new for you in a way, and students will acquire and will see that they are succeeding, and they will be proud of themselves, and so on. Then I will switch to the other, the following example, which is, so we did the LED without resistor, the two LEDs. Now the push button. And here the push button, it's here. Tinkersys, so I can open it. Hope you are enjoying this session. I don't know if you can talk since I've muted you. Can you talk? Well, it's mute. تنشوف شو عم بتقولوا على ال yes okay good okay killed مين عم بيقول لي kill the dog okay it's for my son mute all current and new participant okay no sorry so the push button it's another story look here if I run the simulator So the push button is an input button. It's not an out, it's an input device. It's not an output device. So I have to click on the, once I click, the push button is on. It's an amazing project and the push button is used for many, many, many utilities. Even you can put more than one push button, okay, to control motors, LEDs, any kind of pumps, maybe water pump sensors and so on. So I'll try to explain you since here we have two components, the LED and the push button. So first, the LED, as in the previous program, it's added to the pin number 7, okay? And the push button is added on digital pin 2. But now you will tell me that this setup of the circuit is a little bit complicated for us. Here, I can advise you to go through YouTube and to watch more than one video explaining how a push button work or function. I mean, there is four legs for the push button. Let me show you. There is one leg, another one leg, a third leg, and a fourth leg. Those legs are connected together, and those legs are connected together. And when the button, the push button, as now it's better, I guess. And when the push button is not pressed, okay, there is no link between the two part of the, so the current will not pass. The circuit is open. And when the push button is pressed, I mean, this leg will connect to this leg and the current will pass. That's why always you have to link the push button in a diagonal way. So it means that, as you can see here, I program this leg, or I link this leg and this leg. So once the push button is clicked, all right, the LED will illuminate, as you can see here. Now, to explain, there is an electronic definition here, a little bit weird for us, difficult for us. No problem, I believe. You can explain it to your students as you understand it. That means this resistor of 1 kilo ohm, okay, will kill or will stop any current to pass, even if it's a minimal current, in order to make sure that no current is passing to turn off the LED. So if you do not insert this resistor, always the current will pass, even if you did not press on the push button, and by that the LED will be illuminated. Now, you have to memorize this this scenario, this theme, okay, and apply it with your student. Even in the book, I guess, in grade 10 and in grade 11, there is a lesson for the push button. So you have to memorize how the setup is done. From 5 volt, I link to this horizontal row and I'll give to this leg. And from the pin 2, I will link the other, the second leg, the diagonal way. And then I will put a resistor in order to kill any signal that that will may pass. So I will open the code, and you will see that it's really not complicated at all. I've created a variable called button state or B state, okay? And I've moved the block, set the B state to read the digital pin on 2. The block input read digital pin on 2, it means to read the status of the pin, if it's pressed or no. And here I have two options, as we said, for digital pins. If it's pressed, it's high. If it's not pressed, it's low. So even high, even low. So as you can see, I insert a if-else statement block, and I've inserted in it a mathematical block, which is the compare. And I've inserted the variable B state in a first part of the comparison, and in the second one, high, and then I choose the comparison equal. And if the it's high, I mean I have to set the pin 7 to high. Shuyan is pin 7 to high, it's for the LED to illuminate, and else to turn off. So by those projects, as you can see, the push button now, it's almost done. You can make the idea of Arduino clear, near to the students in order to understand. And even if they don't have the the hardware, they can imagine and understand. And once you gave them the hardware, I believe they can succeed in doing those projects. So here, one second. So here, the project of building a simple circuit with a push button, it's done. I will go through another one, which is the ultrasonic sensor. The ultrasonic sensor is to detect measurement. It's like ultrasonic sensor. It's a really simple project. So now we've done 4 lessons with the ultrasonic. I hope it will not. Do not forget to send me your request for certification in order to prepare you the certification. Okay, so for the ultrasonic, I've already explained that it's an input device that will measure the distance detected in front of it. So the pins are already clear in front of me, ground, 5 volt, and SIG. The SIG, it's the digital pin that will detect the echo pin and the trig pin that will be sent and come back in order it detects an obstacle. So what I've done here is very simple. The 5 volt, as you can see, it's linked to the plus sign here. And from here, I connect a cable to the 5 volt. The other one is for the ground. As you can see here, the ground, it's connected to the ground. And the SIG pin is connected to A0. It's not a digital pin, it's an analog pin, since the values detected by the ultrasonic sensors sensor are not 0 or 1. They are many values depending on the distance that is detected. And this is it without any addition. Of course, we can add LEDs, we can add a buzzer in order to say that if the object detected is less than 10, then the red LED will be displayed, will be illuminated, and so on. But here, you can give it an additional exercise for students. You cannot start with it for the time being, and for the 40 minutes or 50 minutes to start with, all you can do with them is to make the circuit with the ultrasonic sensor and to program it and to test it and to answer to all the questions students may have. So once I click on the code, you will be a little bit surprised that the code will be just one line, okay? One line. And you have to know that I did not explain it the last time. Maybe I explain it. And next week, if you see the program of next week, it's Arduino manipulating the serial monitor screen and knowing better the Arduino language. So the monitor screen, you can see it down here, okay? It's like a screen that gives us the values detected by any object, a motor, a temperature, a distance, any kind of information. So the blocks that I've used are very simple. From the output, I select the block print to serial monitor, okay? And from the input device, I've inserted the ultrasonic sensor. I will show it to you. Okay, distance sensor on trigger pin A0, since I've inserted the ultrasonic sensor data pin to A0, okay? And the echo pin and the trigger pin, Triani, the echo pin and the trigger pin, are those two LEDs that one, it will send the wave and the other will receive it in order to calculate the distance, okay? And this skills are developed in physics, I believe in grade 10 or 11, I don't know. So, and then here we'll specify in centimeter, okay, or an inch, with new line or without new line. So look here, when once I will make it, you will see why I'm making it smaller. So once I click on start simulation, okay, look here, it's displaying 287 centimeter. It's the maximum value that can detect. Once I click on the ultrasonic sensor, look how amazing it is. It shows me the range of distance the ultrasonic sensor can measure. And assuming that this ball is the object. So if I click it and I move it here, it's like now 86 centimeter. If I move it, I place it here, it's like 34 centimeter. If I put it here, it's out of range, so it cannot detect. So the minimum value is 34 centimeter and the maximum value is 200 or 300 centimeter. But the real one the real ultrasonic sensor, this one, can measure, I believe, like 3 or 4 centimeters. Okay, so I click again and I can move in order to have the values. And of course, I can complete my programming by adding additional component like the LEDs or like motors. And if there is something really near, I can ask my motor, if I attach an arm, to close or to open a specific door, let's say. So we can imagine many scenario for this issue. I will stop. Okay, it's done this one. So as you can see, the programming part is really simple, but you have to explain them how an ultrasonic function. So I will select my piezo project, which is a project that will reproduce a sound, the piezo sound. It is, it's here. Also, it's a simple project, but believe me, once you develop projects one by one, it's easy for students later on to make a mixture between them and to create complicated projects. So here, as you can see, project is done like an Arduino board, a breadboard, the piezo, it's inserted, and here it's the negative pole, and here it's the positive pole. And of course, I have to protect the piezo by 1 kilo ohm resistor. That's it. It's very simple. I select from the ground and from the 5 volt. Actually, the 5 volt is not needed. Okay. And then I will go to the code. And as you can see here, I've created a variable called TT. I will repeat 10 times. I will play speaker on pin 13, since the piezo is connected to pin 13, with tone 60. I can change the tone here. You can try it. I don't have in mind the tones. For 1 second, turn off the speaker on pin 13. Okay, wait TT seconds, and first round it for 1 second, and then I've added a block to change the value of TT by 1 second. So I will run the just let me share with you with sound. I believe stop share. Maybe I have to share with you share sound. Okay, share. I hope you will hear now the voice. Pin 13. Sorry, you can hear? أنا ما عم بسمع عندي. Just 1 second, please. سوري عم تسمعوا؟ عم تسمعوا صوت البزر؟ اوكي نو اوكي I don't know. Actually, it was working. ما عم بعرف شو صار معي. ما غريب. Strange. The block is correct. It's pin 13. Turn off speaker on pin. on 10/13. It's a little bit strange. Now it's working. You can hear. Can you hear now? Still no. Okay. Now it's working. خليني أعمل share screen with sound. Okay. Start simulation. Okay. هلا راح you will see that. You will see that now the delay is bigger from one turn to another turn. Okay, great. You are hearing. So from one turn to another, the value of TT is higher, and then you can see that the delay is bigger since the delay is TT seconds. Turn off speaker on pin 13. I don't know why it's not working. Anyhow, okay, I will close the code here and I will terminate by the last project I've created for today, which is hope for next week. I will show you more complicated, where I've linked more than one component. I mean, ultrasonic sensor plus LED or plus motor rotation sensor, to show you how they are working together. So this one is for the RGB, the red, green, blue LED, where we can create multiple combination of colors. I have my internet a little bit weak here. It's not opening. Just give me. Sorry for. Why it's not opening. I'll try another time. Okay. The RGB project, it's like a three LED in one. So we'll need three resistors. Okay, since the RGB LED has four legs, one for ground, one for the red color, for the green color, and for the, as you can see here, this one is for the ground. This one is for the terminal two and terminal two, but for the different digital pin 10, 9, 10, 11. Since the combination of color will reproduce a specific and color. As you can see, the value of the resistors are 220 ohms. If I go through the code, you will see that there is a block for the set RGB color in pin. And here it's very clear, very simple to program. Like here we have 9, 10, 11, since the digital pins are on 9, 10, 11, wait 1 second, set it to black, and then here set RGB red 9, 10, 11 to yellow. If I click on the text base, you can see that it's very simple. There is two procedures. The first one, the setup procedure, and the second one, the loop. And here I have a counter for like 10 times. Okay. that will combine the colors. I will try to run it. And you'll see that the RGB LED is blinking for two colors. Maybe it's not exactly the same colors as we show in the combination of code, but it's working like this. Okay, so I will stop the simulation. I will stop the share. It's like we are here now, 1 hour 20. So I'd like to hear from you, even if you want to send it by WhatsApp, just to tell me if, as usual, I ask you to unmute yourself if you want. I thank you for being with us for this 1 hour 20 minutes. I hope that I delivered a content that is useful for you and for your students. I highly advise you, if you are not using our curriculum, really to take a look at it, since we are a pioneer in the market in order to introduce all this technology. And believe me, for next year, grade 4, 5, 6, you will see that the microbit controller, the microcontroller microbit is integrated in the program. So imagine your kids, your students in grade 4, 5, 6, after 3, 4 years, they will reach a higher level of knowledge and concept in coding, in microcontrollers, and in robotics. So this is the first step, I believe, in microcontrollers, in order to understand how to teach your students, since the hardware, sometimes it's difficult to have. So you have the solution, and you are opening the door to your students in order to discover this new world. I really thank you. And any recommendation you can send to me by WhatsApp. And please do not forget to send all your data here in order to send you your certificate of participation, the link of this video, and the link of the PowerPoint presentation. I really thank you. And if anybody has any question, I will stay here with you for like 5 minutes max in order to answer you. Go ahead. Thank you. هل عنده شي سؤال؟
مساء الخير مسيو سام.
يعطيك العافية.
طبعا مرسي لي كثير for this session. يعني it was a it was my first time to drag me to be interested like this, and I would start to see your links to cover what I've missed. But I have a question. If I will introduce this to the students, I will start with a ready-made project with a simple tools, as you said, these three lessons I will start with, but I need like a model, and not just a LED or two LEDs to blink in front of them, but also something from real life, so they can start to imagine what they can do with this. And how can they go far if they are getting deeper in learning this? So how can we get this, even if it's it's ready on the internet? So we can. I need a place to get ready.
Fatin, just to be clear, for students, the problem is like from. Year from 1 year from now, we have the corona problem, the transportation, the shipment, and so on. So even I cannot even visit and make visits in order to be near you. But the problem is, once the corona problem is solved, all students, all schools adopting our curriculum and using the Arduino for the grades, they will have the material free as hardware, not just the LED. Even the sensors, all I've showed you are in the package. We've already done a package in order to send it to you, but unfortunately now we cannot make this shipment due to Corona. Regarding the projects, you cannot go directly through complicated project unless you introduce simple one to your students. Of course, if you are teaching grade 11 and 12, it will be done quickly. But if you are teaching lower grades, believe me, the project of the LED will take an effort from you, and it will take time for your students in order to understand what's going on.
I know, but if I'm teaching primary students like grade one paint, before I start to show them the tools and how I will draw, I like always to show them a final paint that I did. I was drawing.
Okay.
Then I will show them, let's go in steps how to make this, even if it will take many sessions. But okay. I want to show the final result, and okay. Then I go from scratch, how can we reach this? You got my point?
So you are asking how we can show students ready-made projects in Arduino to make them understand what they can make in real projects.
Yes, sure. And to start to learn this.
Of course, we have on our YouTube channel at least 6 to 7 projects, I think, that we've made for all sensors that we have, the water level, the temperature, the rain sensor, that are working in real, and you can show them to students in order to make them understand the idea of the final project.
Okay, thank you. I will go and check. Thank you so much.
Any help? Thank you for today's session. You know that we can go through WhatsApp and deliver
you
WhatsApp. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Ya ahla wa sahla. Any other question?